Good morning, everyone. We have with us Kirtana, my aunt, and she has studied B Pharmacy, and currently she's going to be starting M Pharmacy, and my friend Likhit. So we'll be asking her a few questions about what she knows about the pharma industry to develop a basic understanding of the industry, the ins and outs, as part of our career guidance program. So thank you for spending time with us, and shall we begin?
So overall questionaries or doubts regarding pharmacy.
So first, could you tell us about yourself? Could you tell us about yourself?
Yourself, okay. Yeah, hello, I'm Kirtana, and recently I studied B Pharmacy and I completed it with a great score. And I'm going to pursue my M Pharmacy in pharmaceutics. So yeah, that's it.
So did anybody inspire you, or was it your own interest to study pharmacy?
Basically I did my BPC. I thought I would go into agricultural studies, but fortunately or unfortunately I came into this field. Later on I got interested into it. My dad forced me to join into this, but later after first semester or second semester I got interested, so it was good.
So, are there any kind of aptitude or skills which you require for this profession?
No, not needed.
Like any degrees, like the B Pharmacy, no, pharmacy, as you were telling.
You at the plus one or plus two, you can take BPC or MPC. To pursue B Pharmacy, you can come through MPC or BPC. If you are MPC student at first year, you will be reading biology regarding science subject first year, okay, at first sem. If you are BPC student, you will get to know mathematics. That is the only difference. So you may not be needed aptitudes or not needed. Those are not needed. Just MPC or BPC. Basic knowledge is enough.
Mm-hmm. And so are there any options in this industry, like other than pharmacy, like if you're taking BPC or MPC?
Yeah, there are lot of options. You'll get to know when you're into that particular stream, okay? When you're, I don't know about MPC, but basic knowledge I know about regarding MPC whole subject. But BPC, doctor, dental, agricultural, veterinary, homeo, Ayurveda, pharmacy, PharmD, D-Pharm, like biotechnology. So they are like vast.
So when you study B Pharmacy, like are there any like specific branches which you can choose? For example, if we study B-Tech, we can choose AIML, or we can choose
Basically, pharmacy is the whole title. Okay, in pharmacy we had D-Pharm, B Pharmacy, and PharmD. Okay, the main difference is like D-Pharm means diploma in pharmacy. Okay, B Pharmacy means Bachelor of Pharmacy. PharmD means Doctor of Pharmacy. Okay, D-Pharm is like, long ago students used to choose D-Pharm because it's a diploma in pharmacy and I think it's a 3 years course. Yeah, nowadays most of the students are choosing B Pharmacy because it's a 4 years course and basic degree. Okay, it's a Bachelor of Pharmacy and it is a like reputed kind of thing. Okay, and D-Pharm, it's a 6 years course. whole degree plus, it includes degree plus PG, because doctor of pharmacy means, okay, I'll say the order, doctor, farm, D farm student and B farm student. Okay, there is a difference between these three posts. Can you get this or I can?
Yeah, it's understand.
Okay, thank you. Okay, in general, doctor must be at the top, okay? Under the doctor, D-Pharm students are like, they prescribe medicines. If a patient is there, before doctor arrives to the patient, D-Pharm, PharmD students will go there and they'll know the disease and they'll prescribe the medicines. Later, doctor will come in, will evaluate those medicines, whether he prescribed right or wrong, okay? In general, the course is like that, but in reality, it was not like that. Okay. After, the prescribed medicines will be given to our pharmacists who are in the pharmacy. We will be give the medicines to the patients. That is the degree, like that.
So, like after we study B pharmacy and M pharmacy, like what career options are available in the pharma industry?
Okay. After B pharmacy, if you are able to do a job, there are many job opportunities because it's just a B pharmacy. So there is no any particular way. If we did M pharmacy, we have, like M pharmacy has several courses. Okay, see, I'm going to study M pharmacy right now. There are some courses, particular, there is a pharmaceutics, industrial pharmacy. So if I studied pharmaceutics, I have to go only pharmaceutical field. If I did M pharmacy, but if you're done with only B pharmacy, so you can go like, you can do jobs in industrial work or pharmacy. You can keep your own pharmacy or you can go like big pharmaceutical companies are like Sun, Cipla, like this big companies are there. So you can go there and you can take any job opportunities or else you can do in industrial works or you can go research. You cannot be after a B pharmacy. So like this small jobs can be allotted. After B pharmacy, not only M pharmacy is the only way. There are like several courses. Like, you know, MPC students, when they are done with BTech, they'll choose C++, Java. Do you have any idea? Like that. Pharmacy students also has some courses like pharmacovigilance, medical coding, SARS, etc. Like there are 6 to 7 basic courses are there. By doing those courses, they can be going to several jobs regarding those courses. After B pharmacy, those are like 3 months, 6 months courses. That's it. Otherwise, you can do M pharmacy in particular subject. You can go regarding those subjects. So for example, if you took industrial pharmacy and M pharmacy, you're industrial in the sense you can imagine what must be having in the industry, machines, machineries, making of tablets. So you'll be getting to those jobs. If you are into hospital pharmacy, just elaborate the title. Okay. Hospital in the sense, the person who must be in the hospital pharmacy. You'll get to know the whole pharmacy environment. Okay, that's the only difference by getting B pharmacy and M pharmacy. Are you getting?
Yeah, it's just getting
clear or?
Okay. So what do you think are the challenges right now the pharma industry is facing?
Okay, challenge. If you're, pharma industry or B pharmacy?
The industry as a whole.
It was difficult to get job opportunities. Okay. I mean, job opportunities are like a lot, but money is like, less. Okay. At starting, it will be like 15,000, 10,000 only. Because in our country, pharmacists are like a number of pharmacists, but they are giving jobs to everyone other than pharmacists. So pharmacists are getting less opportunities through this. This is the main problem. Pharmacists are like, they are not getting well-known opportunities. You can, for example, let us take the COVID situation whole. Okay. They have supplied many of vaccines and number of vaccines, right? In reality, they have to take only pharmacists to make vaccines or to get filled into the vial. Okay. But they are not taking only pharmacists, they are taking other people also. So how can a pharmacist get a right opportunity to prove himself? Did you get the point?
Mm-hmm.
So that's the only problem.
So I have a question.
It's not about only money, because we have to prove ourselves, right?
Yeah.
The main problem, if you're capable of doing research and the whole thing, you have to be like, prove yourself. You have to get satisfied. If you're not satisfied in this field, why are you in this field? Right. That's the whole problem.
Okay.
So after our studies and higher studies in pharmacy are done, like if we get into a pharma company, like what roles can we take up? For example, a research scientist or something else. Could you give a few names for the roles?
Drug inspector, drug manager. Okay. Sorry, I have missed one point. Drug manager, we'll get the drug manager post when we have done MBA, pharma MBA. There is also pharma MBA. Okay. Okay, drug manager. We can get government jobs also, like drug inspector is a government job. And also we can get bank jobs, because they are connected genre wise, but it is difficult, but we can try it. In every genre, there is a SBI main branch. So in that branch, one doctor and one pharmacist to be allotted. So those jobs we can get those jobs. Okay, drug inspector, drug manager, pharmacist. There are like a number of options.
So, like, what are the long-term career prospects for people who take up this career? Like, let's say they take up a job in any company. Like, in a few years, what can they expect? Will they get into a higher role or, could you tell us in detail about it?
Yeah, I cannot explain that because I was still in this stage. So, I can give you a rough idea because I don't know whether they will hire, they'll get promotion or not, because I was not into job right now. So I'll just give the brief. Okay. At first, if you are into industrial pharmacy field, it's just an example. At first, you'll work at machineries. Okay. Later, you'll get on to management. Okay. And after I don't know whether this was right or not, but I was like imagining or like that. Okay. And after that, you'll get into packing. Okay. I don't know regarding this, so I can't give you an exact answer.
Yeah, rough idea. Yeah, brief.
Yeah.
Yeah, like you can go ahead with the next question.
Yeah, so is there anything in this career which you like? Like anything in particular favorite, like about research or doing something?
Okay. If you are really into chemistry, if you are really interested in chemistry, or you you like to get to know new things or you like to experiment the whole things, you're like perfect for this field. In any field, I mean, in any category like medicines or machines or anything, if you are interested to know a new thing, okay, you are the perfect person to this field. Because when I was studying B-pharmacy, experiments are done. Okay, like making tablets, making lotions, making creams. We were like excited. You know, we'll daily use lotions, right? Lotions are used daily. We were excited because I have made that cream, you know, and I know the new thing. So that was like very exciting. And if you are, I mean, really good in chemistry and you are really interested in studying or you are really interested in researching things, you can like get on into this field. Because our pharmacy, M-pharmacy, you'll get into research and development. You'll get to know new things more and more. So I would prefer if you are into chemistry, then you can rock this pharmacy field.
So what did you study in B pharmacy? Like, could you give us an idea, like what things are covered when we study B pharmacy?
Yeah, okay. First semester, everyone are afraid of mathematics, right? Most of the BIPC students are chosen BIPC because to avoid maths. Around 70% of the people choose BIPC because they can avoid maths. So my friends are like afraid of mathematics. At first them, maths will be there. That's the only problem for the people who has chosen BIPC to avoid maths. Okay? But that was good because in pharmacy, if you are into any field, mathematics is like needed to evaluate the measurements or to calculate anything. Maths is needed. So that was the good thing that I enjoyed because I know maths very well. Everyone don't know maths around me, but I have enjoyed a lot. Okay, that was the best thing. And also, as I said earlier, you can know what are the elements you are using in your daily life. Okay, you are put on lotions, but you don't know what are the ingredients present in the lotion. If you are studying a pharmacy, B pharmacy, you'll get to know, okay, this product has been used. So at that time, you'll always check the products, what you will be using in your daily life, right? If you are using a shampoo, you can see, okay, this product I have studied in this, like that. You'll get to know, you will connect your own life into study life, right? Okay, when we are preparing paracetamol, we are like totally excited, you know. Nowadays we are using paracetamol like peanuts, right? If cold, fever, body pains, we'll take paracetamol. So you'll get to know what are the ingredients, how much amount of paracetamol will work on us. Okay, how much amount of paracetamol, if we taken beyond the amount, what will happen to us? You'll get to know. If you are having your grandparents in your house, you will get to know, okay, why these many of medicines are used. You'll get to know, like, you'll connect to your real life and your study life. That is the main exciting thing in this field. And also, cosmetics also to be are done in this pharmacy field. Lipsticks, powders, creams, cosmetics also done in this field. So in my pharmacy days, these are like memorable and these are good things that has happened.
So what does it mean to be a pharmacist? What does it mean to be a pharmacist? Like, what is the feeling of like helping others and everything?
Yeah, what does it mean? Means, you know, see, pharmacy means not only prescribing medicines, okay? It doesn't mean if you are studying pharmacy, you will get to know all the medicines. If you are into the field around 5 years or 10 years, then only you will get to know the medicines. Because I'll take industrial pharmacy, M pharmacy. So how can I know the particular medicines? So if you are really good at this, you'll get to know, okay, for this disease, this medicine is okay. So like that, I cannot be always helpful to people or suggest medicines, but I enjoy that. Okay. At least I can Google it and I can tell, okay, this is okay. But I can say the side effects of every medicine. Because in allopathy, each and every medicine has its side effects. So the person who has studied pharmacy doesn't mean that he can prescribe any medicine. So you cannot take that into mind that, this sister has studied pharmacy, she knows everything. So just take that thought out of your mind, okay? If you are studying a pharmacy, you'll get to know the things. If you're really good at it, you can know. If B pharmacy, you will get to know creams, medicines, not only these, everything are mixed, okay? You cannot remember in these 4 years, you just cannot remember all those medicines. So that will be good. If I am into completely medicine field, then I'll be happy. I don't know what was the feeling of that because I'm not into the medicine field completely, right? So I cannot tell you. But based on our friends or seniors, they are good. Like suggesting medicines or doing industrial works or whatever related to pharmacy, they are very satisfied and they're very good.
So, what are your strengths and weaknesses in the pharma subject? Like,
okay. Strengths are like, to get to know new things are like basic strength, because if first day you know the new thing, and second you will be enthusiastic, right? Okay, I'll get to know the other new thing. With that strength only, I have got excited and I completed my B pharmacy. Day by day, you'll get, because every day there will be experiment section. So you'll get to know new thing daily. If you're really, as I told you earlier, if you're really into chemistry, you'll get excited. That is the only strength in the pharmacy field. You have to be excited to go to the college, right? If you're not interested in your college, how can you? So every day you will get to the new things. That is the only strength. And I was like very excited to know, you know, being a girl, we like cosmetics, we like lipsticks. So we were like very interested to go to the college. If today was a lipstick experiment, we'll go to get ready like that. So that was the only strength. And also you have to be quick learner, you know. There are like lot of medicines and number of medicines, because there are, as you know, there are many of diseases. So each and every disease has like lot of medicines. So you have to be a quick learner, if I'm not wrong. If you are that, that is your strength, which I not have. And weakness. Okay. Weaknesses, sir. You must not be afraid of anything. Okay. Yeah. There are chemicals, like if you add a more amount of chemical that may lead into something or dangerous. Okay. You must be always, like brave hearted, like that. So you must not be afraid of doing anything. Being a chemist or being a pharmacist or studying a pharmacy student, you have to be always, what will happen if I add this, if I add that, okay? Then you'll get to know the new thing, right? If you just once try, for example, you take a powder and take oil, what will happen? Nothing will happen. It's just become a lotion or cream. Like that, you have to... make things of your own. You should not be get afraid of what will happen if I add this or that, what will happen. You should not be afraid of doing anything in this field. If you had that in your brain, that is the most weakest situation. Okay. If you are preparing a tablet in your experiments, what will happen if you add more amount of there are like names, you know, which you don't like, binding agents, drying, these are like the such names. If you add more amount of that, what will happen? It will not break. That's it. Other than that, will not happen anything. So you have to be confident about what you are doing. Because if that experiment was gone wrong, you'll get to know a new thing, right? Because, okay, what happened? You'll evaluate what happened, how much amount I have added. So you should not be afraid whatever you are doing. You just be confident and go like that. That's it. That's it.
Rishik, I think, ask the final question.
So, finally, I would like to ask, what would you tell to aspiring chemists and druggists and pharmacists? And would you recommend this profession to everyone who is interested in chemistry?
Yeah. As I told you, if you are into chemistry or if you are a chemistry person, this profession will like help you a lot, and you can rock this profession. You know, if you are into chemistry, as I told you, you can get to know, if you are wrong in one experiment, you'll get to know the new thing. So I'll suggest to all chemistry lovers who are who are interested to know new things, or who are not afraid, I'll definitely suggest this field, or druggist, or either whatever chemistry field, pharmacy field, I'll suggest them. They should never be afraid of anything. They must be confident about what they are doing. That's it. That is the only main point. Whatever happens, happens. But you must be confident on you and what are you doing. So that's the only point. As a chemist, and many things will happen. Even the whole laboratory may burn. That's it. That's the only dangerous thing, right? But you'll get to know the new thing, right? Okay, this is the worst case. If I add this, this will burn. That's it. But everyone, you must be, everyone should be careful. That's it. That is the only point. So otherwise, you will just love this field. As I told you, you can connect your daily life to your steady life so that you will be encouraged by you. It will be like good.
So that's all. Thank you so much for your time. We got to know a lot about like all the options in the pharma industry and what we can study, what we'll be able to learn. So thank you so much for your time and have a nice day.
Welcome. It's good to talk to you.